We have Chance Neese, Human Resources Business Partner at Jacobs Engineering. Tell us a little bit about what they're up to.
Hi, everyone. Well, I'm happy to be here with you today representing Jacobs to talk through from the STEM industry and from a STEM company how we can help support this initiative here. And so what I wanted to kick off with first is to bring a little bit of our culture to this meeting. And so something from Jacobs senior leadership all the way down to any employee is our culture of caring. And so I thought this was a fitting culture of caring slide to share when we talk about all this knowledge that we're sharing with everyone on this call. I know we've heard of knowledge as power, but this this phrase, knowledge is empowering, really stood out to me. And I borrowed some tactics here from a website, and you'll see that I've put some in green that I think really are resonating. So knowledge overcomes fear. Knowledge breaks down barriers and facilitates communication. Knowledge reveals the reasons behind the actions. Knowledge leads to intelligent decisions, or at least it helps create an opportunity to make intelligent decisions. Knowledge is motivating and empowering. Knowledge encourages involvement and breeds a feeling of ownership. And knowledge creates opportunities. So just something to bring a little bit of our culture here to this audience and share that with you all. So just a quick agenda of what I wanted to share in my briefing today. So I'm going to do a quick overview, a little bit about me. We're going to talk about what Jacobs does, and then specifically where my site is located, what we do, the types of jobs and career fields that work at my location. We'll dive in more to the careers and talk about entry-level positions, some educational requirements and skills for those positions, pay, training, continuing education, and other benefits that Jacobs offers to continue to help people advance themselves once they're an employee of Jacobs. And then I'll leave you with some advice and thoughts from me on just encouragement if just starting out or interested in the industry, and then if there's any job field career overlap amongst the STEM industries. So just a quick bit about me. My name is Chance Neese. My pronouns are he, him, his. On our contract here at my location, I'm a human resources business partner. I've been with Jacobs for 2.5 years. My background is very distant from STEM. My background is actually in retail. I spent 15.5 years in retail. And then through human resources, use that as the vehicle to transition over to a STEM industry. So I spent the last 7.5 years of my time with Target, actually, in human resources, and then joined Jacobs back in 2019 as an HR business partner. And it's been amazing since being part of the team. So a little bit about our job duties on the HR side, all things people related that you can imagine, including some recruitment, compensation, onboarding, benefits, employee relations, talent development, anything that you can think of from the employee life cycle. We're here to help support those processes for our managers and our employees. And then some extracurricular that I do to support our contract. I am the local ambassador for our LGBTQIA+ employee network. The name of that network is PRISM. And we actually have a total of 8 employee networks as a company that give our employees a chance to feel connected to multiple teams around the company. So what does Jacobs do? Jacobs, In talking with some of the other presenters right before our actual call started, I know there's some connections with what Jacobs does. We're a global company. We have 55,000 people in 2 lines of businesses throughout the entire world. We do lead the global professional services sector, providing solutions for a more connected, sustainable world. Our tagline here, challenging today and reinventing tomorrow, was part of our rebranding back in 2020 to really bring Jacobs to the forefront of of our industry. A little bit about our 2 lines of business. So Critical Mission Solutions is a line of business that I sit in. And this focuses on a lot of our government and commercial customers. So think NASA centers, Department of Defense. Jacobs actually has a presence at every NASA center within the US. And then we're focused in aerospace technology and nuclear expertise as well. Cybersecurity is looped into Critical Mission Solutions. And then in People and Places Solutions, we work on buildings and infrastructure and bridges, water facilities, transportation, technology. I know we've done some work to support buildings and airports throughout the US and throughout the entire globe. So definitely a huge portfolio of work that we do to support. And then a little bit about Jacobs Clear Lake Group. So Jacobs Clear Lake Group sits out in Houston, Texas. We're in the Clear Lake area, right off of Bay Area Boulevard and Space Center, if you're familiar with the area. We're situated very close to NASA's Johnson Space Center. And we are the prime contractor for NASA's JETS contract. And that stands for the JSC Engineering, Technology, and Science contract that, that NASA has. So we've been awarded this contract. And you can see here that our NASA customers include some pretty cool work that we get to do and support. The ISS team, so the International Space Station, and commercial cargo in getting products and supplies back up to the crew on the International Space Station, commercial crew, Orion and the parachute program, Gateway. Most of those customers are within our engineering side of our business. And then on our science side, we have astromaterials research and exploration science. When you think about moon rocks, we actually get to curate the moon rocks that come back from space, which is, it's just really awesome work that our teams get to do. And I think that when you talk with anyone from Jacobs or from Jacobs Clear Lake Group, you can see just through them that the passion for the mission of space exploration it resonates. So when we talk about jobs and career fields that work at my location, and I'm going to talk about really the location out in the Clear Lake Group area, the JETS contract, but this will translate out to our other NASA centers where we have Jacobs presences as well. So we do employ engineers, engineering technologists, technicians, and I have technicians bolded for a reason. I'll come back to that. Scientists, safety, information technology, accounting and finance, and human resources, such as myself. So you'll see that we have our technical work side of our business, and we also have our more administrative parts of our work as well. It takes both parts to make our business work. So the reason that I bolded technicians is because when we talk about what types of entry-level positions we have to offer at Jacobs, I polled some of our managers throughout our NASA centers and locally to find out what positions would be available to individuals that may be coming straight out of high school, maybe not enrolled in two-year college programs yet or certification yet, or maybe they are going to enroll in those programs and they have those 2 years under their belt already. So NASA and Jacobs both offer internship programs. With those internship programs, there may be certain qualifications or requirements that we'll dive into for the specific work or the project that they need. Some of it may not require any experience other than certain coursework related to the project. Others may require some more of that hands-on experience, like what we heard our educational institutions talk about that they offer at their two-year colleges, which I think is phenomenal. We're setting our students up for success. We also we're looking for electronics technicians, lab technicians, desktop support technicians, and shipping and receiving technicians. And these positions are mostly hourly positions. These positions being more entry level are a great way for someone to get their foot into the door at Jacobs, start learning more about our industry, about what we do. And then from those positions, they could continue to propel their career through their own initiative and through the support that Jacobs has to offer them. So diving a little bit more into the educational requirements and skills, I wanted to tackle interns first. So for NASA and for Jacobs, it varies based on the intern project. And I know I mentioned that before. So I really encourage if students are looking at these job descriptions or if educators are looking at the job descriptions to determine how best to equip their students to start applying for roles such as these, take a good look at these job descriptions when applying. Sometimes there's specific coursework that we call out. I know for our Jacobs positions that we offer, we do a really great job of outlining what our requirements are, what our qualifications are, what our preferences are. And so it gives a lot of good detail in those job descriptions. So we want to make sure that you take a look at those. For the electronics technicians, we're looking for analytical problem solving and critical thinking skills, teamwork and interpersonal communication skills, mechanical aptitude, enhanced hand-eye coordination. We understand that some of this may not be fully developed for someone who's coming straight out of high school, but certainly through some of those programs that we heard HCC and Dallas College talk about, there's opportunities out there where students can start to gain some of this experience and the hands-on knowledge. And then I would encourage them to list that as relevant information on their resume, because that's going to stand out for certain positions that we're looking for. lab technicians. This is a lot around maintaining data within the labs. We're also looking for someone who's been familiar with the lab environment before. With our desktop support technicians, I heard Tim talk about some of the computer information technology opportunities and development that they have at Dallas College, which I think is really awesome, because this one was a little bit more challenging for me to pull from our IT managers to find out what qualifications are we looking for, more of an entry level, or do we even look for entry level positions? The answer is yes, but there may be some certifications such as this CompTIA IT Fundamentals or the CompTIA Network Plus certifications. These are affordable certifications that someone can go out and while they're working, maybe not in the STEM industry just yet, but maybe they're working in a retail job like myself before, and they can complete these certifications. And what this shows employers is that you're capable of completing a certification that's dedicated to the work that we're doing in to support our customers and our clients. And so someone that can show their certifications on their resume is also going to stand out to us. We also have shipping and receiving technicians. These soft skills are ability to follow written and verbal instructions, familiarity with shipping and receiving processes, valid driver's license, and ability to pass defensive driving courses. And I think sometimes the challenge with a lot of these technician-like roles is where do I get the experience if I'm not already in the industry? I can tell you, having worked in the retail industry with Target, we had a shipping and receiving department. A lot of companies do. And you know, if students are able to secure jobs in maybe those types of maybe non-STEM companies, but with an idea that they want to use that experience on their resume down the road, then that's going to go a long way. Part of what I do and what I did before in my previous role is really helping people market themselves and look at what roles and responsibilities they have in their current work and how to really apply that to a resume for a position that they're truly passionate about. So I wanted to talk a little bit about pay, training, continuing education, and some other benefits that Jacobs offers. These have always blown me away. We care about people to the core of who we are as a business. Regarding pay, I didn't put financials here because it does vary based on the level of work associated with the position. We do have different pay scales. What I encourage here is for candidates to be transparent with the company about their desired pay and inquire about pay ranges for the position. I know on the Jacobs side, our recruiting team will open up about the level of pay for those positions, and we can really determine in those conversations with the candidate if their desired pay fits within the pay scale that we're looking for. And maybe if it's not, maybe if that position isn't a good fit, is there another position that's a good fit for them that they may also qualify for, but that is within their pay range? So it's not just a no and we shut the door. We certainly have a conversation to see if there's still placement elsewhere. When we talk about training, continuing education, and other benefits, I'm happy to say that we do offer an education assistance or a tuition reimbursement program. There are some eligibility guidelines around this program for our employees. Typically, once you've been there a year, you're eligible for education assistance. What I think is great about this is if you start in one of those entry-level technician-like roles and maybe you don't have a degree yet, but you know that you want to pursue a degree, then Jacobs is going to help you pay for that degree for those courses that are applicable to the work or to the work that you want to perform for the company. And we also have external training reimbursement that we support our employees on. So if there's a certification or an external training that someone wants to go out and research and bring back to us, we'll review that and see if we can reimburse for that external training. There's professional membership dues. For myself, I'm part of the Society of HR Management, and so Jacobs pays for my membership to that organization on an annual basis. It keeps me connected with my network of HR colleagues within our industry and outside of our industry, and I think that's a really great opportunity that Jacobs allows us to have. We also offer in-house training and development. Succession planning may be familiar to some individuals here, but we have when we have our talent or our employees, they're very important to us, and we want to assign them with mentors if they're engaged in doing more, if they've shown interest in doing more. We have LinkedIn learning modules that help our employees grow their knowledge, soft skills, and technical skills. So there's just a vast array of different in-house training and development that we offer. when we talk about more of our benefits, like medical, dental, vision benefits, depending on the employee type, depending on the position that you might be able to secure with Jacobs, if it's for instance, a regular full-time position, then we may be able to provide medical, dental, and vision benefits. So that could be a great offering. And then I know I mentioned before, we have employee networks. There's 8 employee networks or employee resource groups, as some people know them as. And these give our employees an opportunity to really be connected with maybe like-minded individuals or have that community. And we also use those employee networks as a vehicle to continue to help train and develop people and link them up with those mentors that I mentioned. So some great benefits there that we offer. So when I think about an advice and encouragement, and I really, you know, I put this here in thinking of what would I talk to a student about, or someone who's in their early stages of their educational career and determining what they want to do. I think first and foremost, it's important to think about what makes you happy. Is it tinkering with computers? Is it building gadgets? Is it electronics? What is it that you're really passionate about? And then maybe let that help guide you in determining what you want to do for a career, and then your career becomes fun for you too, and it pays you, which is always a win. I do strongly encourage you to involve yourself in school organizations aligned with your career interests and passions, whether that's in high school or in those community colleges or even the universities. It could be robotics programs. It could be, I think that we have engineering organizations at local universities in the Houston area that I've heard about when I go out to career fairs. Wherever you can insert yourself and just learn more and network with people, add it to your resume, do that, it will certainly stand out. I highly encourage leveraging the resources that are already available to you, such as career counseling, resume building, and interviewing techniques. As far as I know, many of our high schools, most of our colleges and universities offer these options and these resources to students, and making sure that the students are aware of these and making sure they get connected with the right folks is important. It helped me throughout my educational career, and I think that's a great benefit. Wanted to also just echo again, paying close attention to job descriptions. And this is something that I think you have to learn over time, but if you're paired up with a career counselor or a resume builder, they can help you with this. Look at what your individual skill set and your experiences are. And for instance, if you've got a background in shipping and receiving, even if it's from a retail organization, and you're applying for a shipping and receiving job over in one of our Jacobs centers that supports NASA, call out that those abilities and those skill sets and those experiences on your resume. Highlight those as something that aligns with the job description requirements, because again, that's going to set our students apart from maybe other applicants potentially that are applying for that same position. And then when possible, seek out affordable training and certification programs. If you are working for a place like Jacobs, we may have options to help reimburse you for those programs. I'm a big fan of career fairs and networking. I've had an opportunity in my role to go out with our recruitment team to career fairs, both at the high schools, at the two-year colleges, at the universities. You get to engage with students. You get to talk about what you do at your job, hear about what they want to do, exchange business cards, whatever that looks like, talk about resumes. And we found some really great talent through career fairs. And then when possible, internships. I heard through HCC and Dallas College that there's some partnerships with universities, and then there's internships with companies. Anytime you can snag an internship and get some more experience related to what that career goal is of yours, snag that, use that internship, learn from it, and then add it to your resume, because that absolutely can be used as some experience. And I can give you just a tidbit here. There are times whenever companies will look at how much experience someone has, and that will maybe change their pay scale. And so those internships could very well count as months or years of experience over what someone else may be presenting on their resume. And maybe it positions someone to be in a different pay scale than a truly entry-level person. And then last but not least, persistence certainly pays off. And so I think that the process of jumping into, I need to find a career, I need to get a degree, it can be overwhelming. Stay the course, be persistent, reach out for help, use the resources that are available, and it'll definitely pay off in the end. And then last but not least, just wanted to say thank you to Kim for bringing me into this and being able to be alongside the other presenters and present to you all. And you've got my contact information here. Again, my name is Chance Neese. I'm an HR business partner with Jacobs and certainly happy to bring you some information from our company today. Kim, I'm going to hand it back over to you.
Awesome. Thank you so much.